here we are. We're at Indian Cave State Park, Nebraska.
Yep, Nebraska.
We had to have a change of plans. We're going to go to Ponca Wilderness area down in Arkansas, but the forecast showed rain for all 3 days, so we opted to go north where there was no rain.
Down the road, black and white cattle roamed in the fields, corn grew up straight. These times have changed since my young life. I never thought I'd see the day. There's houses in the cornfield and falling down barn, and the old dirt road was paved.
This is that first split, number one, right here. So we want to go left, and then when it splits, stay left again, because this longer part is supposed to go along a bluff.
Goes along the bluff.
Yep. So that's what we're gonna do.
Talk of the calm weather of the day. Now these times have changed since my young life. I never thought I'd see the day. There's houses in the cornfield around falling down barn, and the old dirt road was paved. And the old dirt road was paved. Short while ago, I stopped down.
So what'd you find?
Found a papa.
Yeah. It's a lot of them on the ground.
You can smell them.
Uh-huh.
Hopefully I don't regret this.
Yeah, me too. Need the green ones like that one there.
Mm-hmm. Mm. There's some. They're all over, Dad.
Hey, there's
tons of them over here.
There's one right there.
The old dirt road was paved. And the old dirt road was paved.
So far the trail's been interesting. It looks like a bobcat has come through and cut the trail.
Yeah, it's all scraped clean.
It's too cool. I'ma do the things that I wanna do. I ain't gonna wear
go where you're not supposed to go when they tell you not to go. Let's see where it goes. It's not that big of a park. Timberland knows the way to reach the top of the chart.
We started on trail number one, on the Northridge Trail, and we entered, and we went up, and we took the long loop all the way around, came down, went around this area. Instead of being able to go out to the viewing blind and go out to that trail, it was all covered in water. So we've looped down here, and we went up, and went all the way down to here, at the bottom, on the most southern point of the Northridge Trail. And then we saw a trail that said, do not use. So we cut across, and it brought us across these horse trail ridges, and boom, right to the UR here. Now we're at this cabin.
Awesome.
We didn't get lost.
Yeah.
Get some merry-go-round. Look at that thing.
Looks like a lawsuit waiting to happen there.
Yeah, look, they're missing a... They're missing a plank. I don't know about that.
Time to go to school. You're gonna get them all running down here after us.
Yeah, what's going on? Who's doing that?
Damn kids again.
All right, we found trail number two.
lay a couple of pearly flies. That's what I brought to you. I saw you through a broken window with a different point of view. You had signs of depression from a long line of sin. And your face tells a story about the places you have been. I loved you so. I thought you should know. And that muddy water's flowing. And as you take my hand past the creek down by the hollow, through your daddy's land, and I could buy you a diamond, but I cannot change the world, cause I ain't got no money. You'll never be my girl. I thought you should know. You was gonna be a singer and a big movie star, but you can't catch no bricks, baby. And Hollywood is hard. Now you work down at the timeout off of 155, and you're dancing for your dollars, just trying to stay alive. It hurts me so. With your crystal meth, and I plead for your life as it takes you to your death. You make your deal with the devil as your looks begin to fade. I saw you laughing through the tears as you slowly slipped away. I watched you go. I thought you should know.
All right, day two, we're packed up, ready to go. So our navigator's got our plan.
Yeah, so it was a pretty chilly night. A little frosty this morning. So we let everything dry out as best as we could. So we're right here. This is our campsite right here.
Okay.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back out and we're gonna follow this trail around, which should be the rest of two, connects with three. And then we're going to take three up to the road where the lookout and the bathrooms are. And then we're going to take the road down to the shelter. And we're going to hope that we can get some water there. That's the plan since we're almost out of water.
Okay.
I recognize you in your fragile state. No more signs of depression from a long time ago. I throw in a pretty flyer as they slowly laid you low. It was a rose. I thought you should know. And it was a rose. I thought you should know.
We just ran into a gentleman that gave us a little insight on where our water's at.
So we're right here at this shelter next to number four. We need to go back up to the main camp area where they've got water and restrooms and fill up our water. And then go back down. And then we'll go down four. We'll take trail four, cut across here to the road by six, take the road down to seven, take 7, turn right, and follow 7 down as it turns into 8. We'll get down here at the bottom. And once we get to the bottom here, we're going to take trail 9. We're going to take trail 9 up and around all the way to the cave. So that's the plan.
All right. Well, we got our water.
Yep. Now we head back to trail 4.
4. All right.
Let's go.
Onward.
We followed it all the way down to the ravine, came up. So we're actually sitting right here at this corner by number 6 on the side of the road right here. So what we need to do is follow the road up to 7, which will be up to our north on our left. And we'll take 7 and we'll cut right and we'll follow this bluff, from what I understand from that gentleman. And it turns into 8 and brings us down here by the water habitat area.
Okay.
And then from here, we'll cross into 9. So maybe this is a good place for lunch, depending on what time it is.
The stage smells, tells, hells, bells, misspells, knocks me on my knees. It didn't hurt, flirt, blood, squirt, stuff, shirt like me on a tree. After I count down 3 rounds of hell.
8 and 3, which 3 is where we were earlier today when we camped. We came off of 3.
So it does connect to 3 from what it looks like.
It makes it look like it connects to 3.
All right.
We just finished up lunch and we're down here by this fishing spot on this bank, and what we're going to do is we're going to hit this trailhead right here, and then we're going to take 9 down to the split, follow it left, go across the meadow, check out these campsites, see if there's anything good, drop our stuff, and then maybe head up to the cave depending on the time.
Looks like we got trail number 5 junction here. This is off trail number 9.
Pair of boys heading on a road, fire up steel and make some noise, and run that bow and the fiddle in the bright moonlight. Hey, I'll rock you, baby, till tomorrow night. Hey, run on down, steel lights roll, run to your can, run no more, and listen to the sound of that old banjo ring. And girl, don't swear that diamond ring, oh girl, don't swear that thing.
We're up high. It's flat. that. Got a fire ring. That's where you're gonna sleep tonight.
Hey, all you rounders, head on down. Down to the banks where the water's brown. I wanna hear a little fiddle strumming on a flat top ball. Hey, I wanna rock you, baby, till morning, dawn. Hey, right on down, Steelhouse Roll, run to can, run no more, and listen to the sound at all. Yeah,
we just talked to a few hikers that said that 11's kind of overgrown a little bit, so okay. We're gonna go check out 10, find a site, and drop our stuff down first.
Yeah.
Steelhouse Roll, run to your can, run no more, and listen to the sound of that old banjo ring.
This is 11. We've already set up our camp, and so we're going to take an hour or two and go investigate the cave, right?
Yeah, supposedly the trail goes and it loops around a lookout over by the Indian cave.
Yeah.
It's still up to debate whether or not the trail goes to the cave or not, but we're gonna find out.
Now steal ass roll, run to your can, run no more, and listen to the sound of the old banjo ring. And girl, don't swear that diamond ring, oh girl, don't swear that thing. And girl, don't swear that diamond ring, oh girl, don't swear that thing. I said, girl, don't swear that diamond ring, oh girl, don't swear that
thing. All right, so this is trail number 11, where the spur that goes down, actually, this is the cave, this is the trail that goes to the cave.
That's what we think.
But I just went down there a little earlier, and there's a sign down there. You can kind of see it. Trail closed to storm damage. So this probably takes us down there, but I don't think we feel that adventurous today.
Not this late.
Not this late in the day. Nope. Sun is starting to set, and we need to get back to our wonderful campsite. All right.
So this is what we figured out. So we are right here at this really sharp angle right here. And this little scenic overlook right here, this is where we had just stopped, and the parts of the trail that you showed us that were closed is this loop right here.
Yeah.
So they've got this loop down here closed, and this loop is what goes down to the cave.
Yeah.
So you can only go as far as this scenic overlook right now.
Okay.
All right. So, we are right here at the meadow campsite off of trail number 9 and 10. So what we're going to do is we're going to come down and we're going to go back around this way. We're going to follow 10. We're going to go by all these sites. This is supposed to be along the ridge where you can have a lot of views. And then go down the hill. And we're going to go back down to the trailhead where we had stopped for lunch yesterday. And then from there, we're not going to go back up 8 because we found as we were coming down 8, it was extremely steep. So you don't want to go north on 8. That's definitely something you don't want to do. So we're going to follow instead the road. We're going to follow it all the way around. And we're going to follow it back to trailhead 4, which of course we did 4 yesterday. and we're going to go back across four, across that ravine to get to kind of cut through. And then we're going to come back up to the road again. And then we're going to follow the road past where we got water yesterday, up past the main camp. And we're just going to keep following the road and follow the road back up to the truck. And that's the plan.
Yeah.
Okay. So we thought, we also thought about going back on 9 and connecting up to the number 5 trails and going back down this way. Problem is that it doesn't connect right here. You have to go all the way up and all the way back down in order to follow the trail out to the road here. And the other problem we're having is that we both only have about a quarter water left, and we don't know if there's any water throughout here. And so far, there has not been a lot of water along the trails.
No, we've only found 2 places that had water, and that was over here off on trail 4. And a little bit down on trail 9.
So few and far between. So that's the downfall, is you got to be careful. Is you got to plan your water really good.
Yep.
I like digging holes and hiding things inside them. When I grow old, won't forget to find them, 'cause I've got memories and travel like gypsies in the night. I build a home and wait for someone to tear it down, then pack it up in boxes, head for the next town running, 'cause I've got memories and travel like gypsies in the night. I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots. I've got no roots. I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no
We finished. We're back at the truck.
We made it.
That we did.
What's our total mileage?
Well, let's take a peek. Miles.
All right.
17 3/4. Well, we had a good week, a couple of days of backpacking.
Good weather.
Yep.
No rain.
If we went to Arkansas like we planned, no bueno.
No.
Wouldn't have been good. Well, our last few miles were on the road, but I tell you what, I think those first couple of days that we spent on trail 1 and 7 and 4 and 9 and 10 were awesome. I think those were the best trails out here.
Yep, that's what the people we talked to said, that those were the good ones.
Yeah, we didn't get to the rest of them, but I think the trails that we went on were the best. So anyway, we definitely recommend this to anyone. All right, another successful hike.